Righteousness, peace, and joy.
As our partner, we welcome you to today's broadcast and for taking the message of grace around the world through your support. Thanks for making a difference in the world today.
Righteousness, peace, war, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God.
Everybody sing.
Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost.
Oh,
righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God. Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom? Don't you want to be a part? Oh, don't you want to be a part of the kingdom?
Come on.
We glorify the name of God for the special opportunity we have to be blessed this evening again. This is your favorite program, Kingdom Life Half Hour, coming to you from your inspirational station, Echo 89.7 FM. This program comes up from 8:05 to 8:35 every Sunday evening and is brought to you by Kingdom Light Christian Center, also known as Praise Arena. My dear listener out there, God loves you, He cares for you. You know, one thing we always tell people, when you tune to this program and you apply the teaching in every area of your life, people will be coming to ask you for the secret of your success. We have had testimonies of people that apply it to their marriage. They apply it to their children's upbringing. They apply it to their business. They apply it in their relationship. Even people that are employees, they follow this scriptural teaching, practical application of Bible teaching to their day-to-day life, and they stand out. So whatever area of your life, you need divine touch from above. What you do is this: listen to this program, apply the teaching, and great will be your testimonies in Jesus' name.
Amen.
People will be coming to ask you, what is the secret of your success? I'll be telling them, follow me to our Lord Jesus Christ. So my brother, my sister out there, I congratulate you for being part of this program tonight. As I said earlier on, I'm Jumi Adetoye Sholaguju, the minister on this program. I'm not alone in the studio tonight. I have with me my co-presenter, Sister Lua Fumilayo. You are welcome to the program tonight.
Good evening, listener.
Come join the praise at the Next Praise Arena program taking place every last Friday of the month at Nikon Hotel, VGC, Lekki, Lagos, between 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. Sing praises to the Most High and see how all your impossibilities become possible through His grace. Victor Olayeni, Okiki Jesu Gospel Fuji Band, Nife Sax, Tunde and the Beat Creator, and other gospel artists will be there to thrill you to lovely and inspiring songs. Venue again is Nikon Hotel, VGC, Lekki, Lagos, between 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. every last Friday of the month. Come, say eat with praise at the Praise Arena and turn your prayer points to praise points. Host Fumi and Jumi Adetoyeshe Olagunju. Jesus is Lord.
Thank you very much. With us as well is a special guest, a minister in the house with us, a special guest that the Lord is going to use to bless you and I, and that is in person of Dr. James Ape Okai.
Good evening, dear listener.
Thank you very much. In the previous episode, we look at a special message that launched us into the new year, and a message that gives us a guide of what the Lord expects from you and I. By the special grace of God, we'll continue with those teachings. We'll continue with those explanations on what you and I need to do. But before we continue with that series, we'll be having this special message tonight from Dr. James on goal setting. Okay, a lot of people will be saying, well, how come this is what is happening? I've been told in the church, I've been prayed for, that I will succeed in life. This is what will happen to me. And look at what is happening. Look at my situation. The way my economy is, the way my situation has been, nothing is happening, nothing is improving. And the question is this: have you done something differently from the way you have been doing it in the past? So, issues like that require looking inward. Like we said in one of our programs, we said, look, it takes knowing Jesus for you to be saved, but it takes you following His principles, His teaching, for you to succeed in a greater way, greater measure. So tonight we'll be having Dr. James Ape Okai to speak with us on goal setting. Dr. James is a renowned chartered accountant. He's a tax consultant and forensic accountant. He's a businessman, a writer, and a gospel preacher. Amazing. Not only that, we are blessed with Dr. James, who is in the house with us. He is the Vice President of Full Gospel Businessmen Fellowship International, VGC, Lekki Chapter, FGBMFI, Full Gospel Businessmen Fellowship International. So my brother, my sister out there, if you need anybody to tell you, to tell me, to instruct us on how to succeed in a business, how to have effective plan, how to plan ahead for the future, it takes an SME, subject matter expert, loaded, scripturally, anointed, and in the secular world, somebody that is qualified. I'm so happy welcoming Dr. James Akwe Okai, the renowned chartered accountant, the tax consultant, forensic accountant. God bless you, doctor. He's a pastor as well. Thank you very much for being with us on the program tonight, sir.
Good evening, my dear listener. Today, we're going to talk about the goal setting, launching into the new year with a plan. You see, as a child of God, God has destined you to succeed. And there is no reason why you should bring yourself down by the word of your mouth. Because you are the only person that can run yourself down. Because God has put in you whatever it takes for you to succeed. And in this new year, I want you to have a positive thought. Have a positive mind that definitely you are going to succeed. Imagine a ship on the sea that has no particular port of sail. It will sail and sail and sail. There will be no wind that will blow to its favor. Imagine somebody that will just get up in the morning, put on his or her dress, pick up his bag, and goes to the motor garage without a particular place to go to. When you ask such a person, where are you going to? He will tell you, oh, anywhere the vehicle will take me to. Such a person does not have a plan. It means that anywhere the vehicle takes him or her to will be his destination. When you don't have a plan in a particular year, you are just like such a person. Take for instance, you are watching a football match and the players will play for about 90 minutes and there are no goalposts. And I want to tell you that you will agree with me that such a match will be very boring and frustrating because there are no goalposts. So if in a year you don't have a plan set for yourself, you are just like somebody in that match because you have not defined a goal for yourself. Now, what do we understand by goals, by plans, and by resolution for the year? By whatever terminology you want to define them, all of them follow the same principle. It means that you are setting a plan for yourself. You are working out what you want to achieve for that year. So let us just, for the purpose of understanding, define what goal setting is. Goal setting is the process of identifying something that you want to accomplish within a time frame and setting the objective by which you can achieve that. I give you an example. If, for instance, in a new year or in a year, you want to raise the sum of about 600,000 naira, and then you say, oh, how do I raise it? By saving about 50,000 naira per month. It means that at the end of the year, you will have raised the sum of 600,000 naira. By doing this, we can say you have set your financial plan. Setting goals is fundamental to success. Without articulately defining your goals for a year, success will elude you. But my prayer is that in this new year, you will succeed because you know how to plan, how to set your plan, and set the objective of achieving your plan. And with this, you succeed and succeed well.
Amen.
The truth is that you can't get to anywhere until you have clearly defined where that place is that you are going. In Proverbs chapter 23, verse 18, it is written, "For surely there is an end, and their expectation shall not be cut off." What are we talking about? The seasons of life are defined in terms of periodicity. At the end of 12 months, you have a year. At the end of 10 years, you have a decade. It means that your expectation, your result is driven by expectation. Your plans are what your expectations are. And you must have a plan for you to succeed, to have a good result. Now, what are the advantages of goal setting, resolution, or having plans? Number one, I said focus. Goals help you to focus, concentrate, allocate, and manage your time and resources efficiently. Goals will keep you motivated when you feel like giving up. But unlike somebody that doesn't have goals, you won't have a focus. And when you don't have a focus, your result will elude you. But I pray this year that you will focus well and you will achieve your result in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number two, sense of achievement. When you have goals, you have a sense of achievement, a sense of fulfillment. Goal setting helps you to have a feeling of success and achievement. Be you an individual. corporate entity or even a government. That's why government have, you know, rolling plans. They have development plan. Goal setting spurs greater productivity and confidence. Idle time. When you don't have goals set, the tendency is that you are bound to waste time. But I pray that this year, you'll be able to set your goals and you are not going to waste your time. Goal setting helps you to avoid idle time, like I've already said, because you have a focus. Every time will be gainfully deployed by you. Performance measurement. When you have goals, you are able to benchmark your activities. You are able to measure your performance. Which area have I done well? Which areas have I not done well? Goal setting helps you to measure your performance over a time. Then number five, prayer focus. One of the great mistakes that a lot of us make is that we pray and pray and pray. Sometimes we don't even know what we are praying about. That is not what God desired of us. It should be a symbiotic relationship with God. When you pray, God also expects you to do something. And the only way you can know what to do is by setting your plans. And when you set your plans right, when you set your goals and resolution right, you know exactly what to do. My prayer this year is that as you launch into the new year, you'll be able to pray and pray aright in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So now, what are the guides to setting goals? I must tell you that there is no scientific approach to goal setting. There is no mathematical basis like the Y, the X for setting goals for you. But then there are basic principles you must follow in order to get your goals aright. When you read Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20, and it says, "Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us." That is the power of your faith. That means you must believe in whatever you are doing. And when you have asked in the name of Jesus Christ, as written in Matthew chapter 7 verse 7, that says, "Ask and you will receive. Seek and you will find. And that when you knock, it will be opened up to you." When you prayerfully, you think through whatever you desire, God is able to meet you at the point of your need. So thoughts are very key in the process of setting your plan, or setting your goals, or setting your resolutions for the year. You must also learn, in addition to thinking, to use your pen and paper. Because whatever you don't put down, the tendency is that you forget it. A written goal represents a recommitment. Commitment is what separates our dreams from our goals. As you pray and meditate, write down the flashes of inspiration that come to your mind. Never say, "Well, my mind told me." I want to assure you that as you pray, God is the one speaking to you and telling you what to do. You should commit them into writing. Then you must study to acquire knowledge, understanding, and wisdom. Knowledge is information, and understanding is comprehension. Wisdom is application. So when you know something, you need to also understand that thing. And when you understand it, you need to apply it. My prayer is that in this year, as you plan your day, as you plan your month, as you plan every activity you want to indulge on, God will give you the necessary ability to materialize what your plans are. Then you show through goal setting, you are also able to manage your time. Time is a key factor in the business of life. So plan your time well and do little bits of your task, but consistently. In Proverbs chapter 22, verse 29, it is written, "Seest thou a man diligent in his business? He shall stand before kings. He shall not stand before mean men." You should be diligent in whatever you are doing.
Sorry for interjecting. Yeah. About that time management, sir. Yeah. There's something I just want to chip in, and that affects most of us in this part of the world. I learned that the richest countries in the world are not necessarily the countries that have all the best natural resources.
That's right.
In fact, most of them do not have the natural resources that is acclaimed to be the sources of wealth. But those countries are the richest in the world.
Yeah.
Whereas some countries that have natural resources end up being among the poorest in the world.
Yeah.
But they have something in common. Those that are poorest in the world, they lack time management. That is where they waste time, they lose a lot of time in traffic, they don't keep appointments, they're always behind schedule. Whereas the countries that do not have natural resources, but they have effective time management, they plan things well, and they are able to get things done. So just like saying, time is a universal currency.
Yeah.
It is the value you allocate to it that works for you. So I don't know whether I'm in line with what you're saying, sir. Thank you very much, Dr. James.
Yeah,
I'm
Pastor,
sorry for interjecting, sir.
Yeah, Pastor, you have said the written. There is a portion of the Bible that says, there are plenty in the land of the fool, but for lack of wisdom, there is waste. And that's what is happening in the African country. We have so much blessing from God. But because we do not know how to manage our time, because time is a key resource, and that is why we waste so much Otherwise, Africa is not supposed to suffer. Nigeria is not supposed to suffer. But because we don't know how to effectively and efficiently utilize time as a key resource, that is why we have so many waste. And that is why majority are poor. But I want to assure you that at the end of this our discussion, you know how to manage your time well, and you know how to plan your resources and achieve your result and get good results. Then I go on to tell you that you must also make sure that the goal that you are setting are feasible and specific. It is not enough to say, I want to be rich this year. You should be able to specifically define the process, the methodology you want to follow to get it rich. Then you should also know how to be able to measure your goal. And to measure this, you have to quantify the result you are hoping to achieve in terms of figures and time. This will allow you to measure what you have achieved and readjust accordingly. Like if you have defined your goals in terms of time and figure, you'll be able to benchmark, oh, this is what I've achieved so far. This is what I have not achieved. Then you now know how to make whatever adjustment you want to make. Make sure the goal is in your hands. What I mean by this is that you must be able to achieve the goal as a result of your own hard work and the determination, or with the willing assistance of someone already in your network. If you have no control over the outcome, it does not make for a realistic goal. It should be something that you know that is achievable within the ambit of your own personality. Otherwise, it becomes a mere wish. Don't go overboard. What I mean by this is that don't overestimate yourself. You already know what you can do. You already know your capability. We must not be too ambitious about our goal. Reflect on your past and present performance levels, and hence make projections for the new year. Know your strengths and weaknesses and plan honestly so you don't let yourself or your team down. Be flexible. Look at your goal. Are there areas that you need adjustment or readjustment? You should be able to reflect on this. And when adjustments are necessary, you should reflect such adjustment and move ahead. You should have a burning desire. According to Dr. Napoleon Hill, he said you should have a magnificent obsession. Whatever you are doing, you should be involved emotionally. You should be involved actively. Every fiber of your being should be involved in that thing. And it is only there and then that you can have a good success. So I want to tell you that when you go through all this, you should be able to set your goals for the year. What we have discussed today is not exhaustive. There are so many things that you need to learn on your own. But the primary issue is that learn how to set your goals. Because when you don't set your goal, it means that you have not defined yourself for the new year to succeed. But I pray that God will give you the guidance to succeed this year. So as you launch yourself into the new year, I pray that our good God will give you the Solomonic wisdom to know what to do and to do what you know for your good, for the good of mankind, and for the glory of God. May God give you prosperity of the body, prosperity of the soul, prosperity of the spirit, and prosperity of the mind. Remain blessed until we meet again.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. That has been Dr. James Ape Okai, a renowned chartered accountant, tax consultant, forensic accountant, and a minister of the gospel, a businessman, a writer, telling us, not just talking to us hypothetically or just out of the blues, bringing up ideas that are not realistic. He's somebody that Lord has used to bless millions of people in various spheres of life, bringing to us the practical applications of all these teachings on setting goal for the new year. And imagine you and I setting this goal and making even our children, the other member, entire members of the family, to translate the goals on their own within their level. I remember sometimes ago, my wife and I we discovered the children, and Doctor, I will be coming back to you on this, and we asked them to set goal. One of them told us and set the goal as in how many A's he wants to have that year. One of them even told us, Daddy, Mommy, I won't need a lesson teacher. Am I right?
Yeah.
I won't need any lesson teacher. I should be able to achieve this.
Yeah.
Initially, we were a bit scared, as in worried. Hey, you won't need a lesson teacher. I said, I should be able to do it. They were watching from distance. We notified one of the instructors that, please, we may call you any moment from now if things appear not to be working as expected. But lo and behold, that one of our children did it as expected, performed better than the time he was even using a class teacher. We allowed him to run with the goal. The same thing happened to their sister when that one came in and said, look, I'll be able to do this. So goal setting is not limited to academic area.
Yeah.
It could even be applied to it's not limited to business area, to every, other aspect of
every
life.
Every area, every aspect of life, goal setting are relevant. After all, the Bible says, I can do all things through Christ that strengtheneth me. Once you know this and you personalize it, I tell you, you have no limit. You can get to any level. But you see, the challenge that most people always have is that we tend to limit ourselves to what we see in our environment, to what they tell us. But I'm assuring you, I'm telling you that the word of God is real. When you reflect on the word of God that says, I can do all things through Christ that strengtheneth me, it means that you can do all things. The limitation is only yourself. But I pray that in this year, you will not limit yourself and you will get to the level that you desire to be.
Thank you very much, sir, on this setting goals. Please, we'll be glad to have you as a guest on this program and the subsequent issues, by the special grace of God. And my dear brothers, my dear sister out there, as we are setting goals for the year, how amazing, how interesting will it be if you have a study plan, Bible study plan, as a goal for the year, goal that you will read the entire Bible in the year, before the end of the year. And it's very easy nowadays, even on your phone, download the Bible. There are things written there as in Bible plan reading for the year, Bible study reading for the entire year. You have the monthly reading there. And if you say my phone doesn't have such facility, amazing. There are booklets out there being sold, affordable booklets. In fact, some churches have it given out for free on Bible study plan for the year. As you do so, you are becoming stronger, you are becoming empowered, and you are able to do things effectively in every area of your life. So my brother, my sister out there, the Lord has destined you to succeed in every area of your life, has destined you to succeed in what you are doing. But one thing you have to bear in mind is this: while the other aspect of the success is going on, how do we achieve this success? What do we do that makes us to stand out? And that's what we are constantly, why we are constantly reminded on this program. As written in the book of Matthew chapter 5, as recorded there about who we are in Christ. Let's go ahead and read, please. You can go ahead and read.
From verse 14, you are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. Nor do they light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all who are in the house. Verse 16, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven.
Thank you. So as you are setting this goal, you have targets you want to achieve. Don't go about it as in, at all costs, I will do this, violating what the scripture, what our Heavenly Father expects from you and I. No cutting corners. Let your light so shine before God, and they will see your good work, and they will glorify the name of God. You remember, we are told we are the light of the world. We are to shine in the dark world and be the one to illuminate, bring salt into the moral decadence, and make things right. And as you do so, the Lord says, when you write all these goals down, is the one that will accomplish beyond your expectation. And if you are there tonight, you are saying, well, I've been doing this in the past, I've failed in the past, the Lord is saying success is yours from this moment in Jesus' name. We have had the Vice President of the Full Gospel Businessmen Fellowship International, VGC Chapter, that's Dr. James Apoy Okai, explaining to us on setting goal in the year. Whatever goal you have set, the Lord is saying they actualize from this moment in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And I, but that other aspect of the goal, you want to be blessed here on earth and eternity will be sure for you. When you are setting the goal, let this goal also be like what Moses said, number your days, teach us to number our days. And when you are doing this one, you are asking yourself, what is the eventual goal of making heaven? As you do so, you'll be blessed here on earth and eternity will be sure for you in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. For more information, you can link us through our website, praisearena.org, www.praisearena.org, or through our producer, Taiwo Omoshule, Echo 89.7 FM, Lati Jakondewe, Agidingbi. Our email address is kingdomlifefamily@yahoo.com. You can also call us on our telephone line, 0909-328-9075. 0909-328-9075. Sonayo Joseph has been a sound engineer on this program. Remain blessed.
Come join the praise at an Express Arena program taking place every last Friday of the month at Nikon Hotel, VGC, Lekki, Lagos, between 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. Sing praises to the Most High and see how all your impossibilities become possible through His grace. Victor Olayeni, Okiki Jesu Gospel Fuji Band, Nifa Sax, Tunde and the Beat Creator, and other gospel artists will be there to thrill you to lovely and inspiring songs. Venue again is Nikon Hotel, VGC, Lekki, Lagos, between 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. every last Friday of the month. Come, say it with praise at the Praise Arena and turn your prayer points to praise points. Host Fumi and Jumi Adetoyeshe or Lagunju, Jesus is Lord.
Thank you very much, my dear listener out there. In case you need to get across to Dr. James Apeokai, our guest minister on this program, you can reach him through our phone number, that is the Praise Arena phone number, or through the email address. We'll be able to route your inquiries, your details to him, and we'll get in touch with you. I'm Jumi Adetoyesho Lagunju. God loves you. He cares for you. Please, as we always say on this program, let others see Christ in you, in everything you are doing. You should be the Revised Standard Version that they will be reading through your attitude, through your action, through what you are doing. And before you react to people, use the password we always emphasize on this program, WWJD. What will Jesus do? And this will make you to be Christ-like every day. What we say on this program is, obedience to the law of the land is obedience to the word of God. Obey the law enforcement agent, obey the traffic rule on the road, and let people see Christ in you in what you are doing. Be part of this program next week Sunday by 8:05. And please worship with us at Praise Arena. That's Nikon Hotel, VGC, Lekki. From 9 o'clock, you will hear more of these messages and all the talks, tips on success in your area of life. By 9 o'clock, 9 to 10:30, every Sunday morning at Nikon Hotel, VGC, Praise Arena. God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of our broadcast. You can visit our website, www.praisearena.org, to listen to this message and many more. We are believing God for your blessings and for you to partner with us for continuity of this program with other outreaches we are involved in. You can write checks in favor of Kingdom Light Christian Center. Please visit our website for our bank account details for online donation. Thank you for your financial support. Thanks for making a difference in the world today.
Righteousness, peace, and joy.
Righteousness, peace, war, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God.
Everybody sing.
Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost.
Oh,
righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God. Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Don't you wanna be a part? Oh, don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom?
Come on.